In the snow itself, without the presence of any objects,
because its nature is knowing. Just imagine, for the moment, let's imagine that awareness is like empty space. Yeah, imagine the empty space of this room. In fact, take away all the objects in this room, and in fact, take away all the room as well. So there's just empty space, yes? But now, endow this empty space with another quality, which is knowing. So this space is no longer just a physical space, it's a knowing physical space, yes?
Okay.
Yeah. Now, objects start appearing. Go back. This knowing empty space, in which there are no objects, just simply knows itself by being itself, yes? Because its nature is knowing. It's made out of knowing, yeah?
Well, it kind of... Okay, its nature might be knowing, but if there's nothing there to know, it can't comprehend it.
That's quite right. It doesn't know itself as something, but it is knowing. It doesn't need to know something in order to know itself. Because its nature is already knowing. Let's take another analogy. So the sun is shining in the universe, and it's all alone in the universe. No other planets. An alternative Big Bang theory. Yeah, the sun is there, shining in this vast empty space, and the sun has these two qualities, like awareness has two qualities of being and knowing. The sun has two qualities of warmth and light. Yeah, heat and light.
Mm-hmm.
And the sun is just shining in the universe. What does the sun have to do to illumine itself? Nothing. Yeah, because its nature is to illumine. Illumination is not an activity that it does. Illumination is what it is. It illuminates itself just by being itself, not by an activity of doing. It is the illumination of itself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, stay with that yes, and take the sun away, but stay with the yes. Okay. Now replace the sun with just empty space. So now the sun has been removed from the universe, and there's just empty space left. And in just the same way that the sun was warm and light, this empty space is present and aware. It's a physical space, it's a kind of magical, we're making it up. It's a physical space, a vast physical space, which is present, obviously, but it has an quality of being aware. Yeah? Now, what does this empty universe need to do in order to be aware of itself?
Mm-hmm.
Does it have to do engage in some kind of activity in order to be aware of itself? No, its nature is to be aware. Just by being itself, it is aware of itself. Just like the sun, by being itself, illumines itself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Stay with the yes. Now, from this magical, present and aware space, remove the three-dimensional aspect. It's no longer a physical space. Remove all the dimensions from it. It's now a dimensionless space. Yeah? It's still present, and it's still aware. It just no longer exists in three dimensions. Yeah? Now, what does this dimensionless, aware presence need to do in order to be aware of itself?
Well, there's nothing there to be aware of. So
that's very true, but that wasn't the question. That's true. There's nothing there for it to be aware of, but there is itself there. This dimensionless, aware presence. It's true. There was nothing, going back one step, there was nothing in the physical space to be aware of, and yet this physical aware space was just aware of itself by virtue of the fact that its nature was to be aware. It wasn't aware of itself as something. It didn't have to look in the mirror to know that it was there, because there's no mirror there. It's just itself there. But it doesn't need the mirror to look in, because it's made out of knowing or awareness. It can't not be aware. Yeah?
Yeah, it's just you can't really conceptualize it, can you?
That's very true. I mean, we're pushing the mind now to...
I mean, I can see the sun, you know, because it's something you can see. You can imagine a sun and light and
heat. But that's why I'm trying to go from something concrete like the sun to something less concrete like empty space.
Mm.
Each time we remove one layer of concreteness and we end up with just being and awareness. We're pushing the mind to its very limit, trying to...
I make space, though, as you know, it's like an empty box, I suppose, is the closest I can think of as, you know, empty space.
No, that's right. But then we even take away the box and it's still empty space, yes? So we take away all objectivity, it's still empty space. But we now endow this space with awareness or knowing, as well as being present. In other words, this, in just the same way that the sun doesn't need an object to reflect off in order to illumine itself. The sun doesn't have to shine against a mirror in order to light itself up. Just by shining into nothingness, it illumines itself. Likewise, the aware, empty physical space doesn't need an object to reflect off in order to reflect back its own presence, in order to know itself. Likewise, the true, dimensionless, aware presence of ourself doesn't need a body-mind, an object such as a body-mind, in order to reflect itself back to itself. It knows itself by itself, through itself, as itself. It doesn't know itself via an object. The mind can't really go there
because,
you know, the mind is already trespassing when it talks about awareness without an object, because the mind is one of the objects that is supposedly not present there. So how dare this object called thought say anything about awareness without an object? I mean, what does it know about awareness? What does an object know about awareness without an object?
Yeah.
I mean, it should really keep quiet.
Mm.
It's ridiculous.
I will do.
But it's your fault. You asked the question.
It's just that urge, isn't there, to know?
No, but that's good. It's good because what these kind of conversations do, they don't actually, what we're doing with these lines of thinking, we're not really delivering the true answer with the mind. But what we're doing is dismantling all the false evidence, all the evidence that says awareness needs an object to know itself. We think there is evidence for that. We think that we have watertight evidence for the belief that awareness needs the body or the mind in order to reflect itself back to itself. So these conversations that we're having destroy that evidence. That's really as far as they go.
Mm-hmm.
And in that sense, they are valuable. But you're right, again, to be so cautious of going further with the mind, because it really the mind's trespassing there. We can't go further with the mind. We can just go right to the edge and say there's no nothing in our experience to suggest that awareness knows itself via anything other than itself. But then, if we then drop thought and just go to the simple, simple, simple experience of our own being, we know that I am. If I was to ask you, are you present? What would you say?
Of course.
Of course, I am. But how do I know that I am with such certainty? It's because I know that I am. We don't say, of course, I believe that I am. We are absolutely certain of it. In fact, that I am is one of the very few things that we are certain of. We're not certain that this is a chair. We're not certain that this is a world, but we are certain beyond doubt that I am. Whatever I am, I am. And we're sure of it because we know it.
Because there's something to know.
No. Well, there's something to know. It is our own being. It is our own being, but that is not a thing that is known. And if we ask ourselves, who is the I that knows that I am? Am I known by a different I from the I that I am? Or is it the same I that I am that knows that I am? It's the same I. The I that I am is the I that knows that I am, yes? But I am not two things, yeah? I am one thing. So in this one thing, knowing and being, being myself and knowing myself are the same experience. They're not two separate things. It's not one thing to be myself and another thing to know myself. To be myself is to know myself. Yeah. That's awareness's way of knowing itself, by being itself. It doesn't have to know itself as something. Just being itself is its way of knowing itself. Just like the sun, being itself is its way of illuminating itself. So we do know very intimately that awareness knows itself. We don't know it through thought. Thought has no business going there. But just in the simple, it's the most simple experience we know, the simple knowing of our own being. Everybody knows it. Right there, in the simple knowing of our own being, awareness is knowing itself without the mind. It's that simple. It's because it's so simple, so familiar, so ordinary, that we overlook it and we hear these phrases like awareness knowing itself and we think it must be some exotic experience that one in a million enlightened sages has. No. All 7 billion, plus all the animals, plus, in fact, it's not all these different awarenesses. It's just one awareness. Knowing being, written all one word, knowing being itself. And we can add one more word to it. Knowing being loving itself. Because it never knows anything other, anything truly separate from itself. So it's all its experience is only of itself. And that only myselfness of awareness is called love. So the whole substance of experience is made out of awareness, knowing, being, loving itself. Being, knowing, loving. Sat, Chit, Ananda. That is all experience, modulated in the mind, seeming to become name and form, multiplicity and diversity. Namarupa, name and form, Sat, Chit, Ananda. That is the most exquisite, economical formulation of experience that is possible. It includes everything. Don't worry if you can't go there with the mind. You're right, the mind can't go there. Just the simple knowing of your own being. That's it. The knowing, I am. It never leaves you. It's never changed. Julian is one of its names. It never goes anywhere. It wasn't born. It's not going to die. That's all you need to know, all you need to feel know. To see at any moment of your life this being is present. Intimately one with all experience, but independent of it. That's all you need to know. You don't need to understand the theory, the words, the ideas. It's thank you.